commitment to carry out the reform is equally important. We need to identify taxes that offer the greatest potential. For instance, VAT is arguably the most efficient revenue raiser. Hence, placing much emphasis on improving its administration will help improve tax revenue collections. Improving the administration of excise taxation is also seen as a great source of revenue potential for African countries. We need to redefine revenue authorities' strategic orientation. Integrated national IT systems that assigns dedicated integrated national IT systems that assign dedicated storage space for each individual and corporate entity are required. To achieve this, we should pursue the following suggested actions. Conduct a functional review of our revenue authorities, including their organizational structures. Develop a new strategic approach to the emphasis on integration of IT systems. Full digitization and automation of processes and procedures within revenue administrations. For instance, to boost filing of tax returns, we need to introduce EPRT return forms, develop mobile applications for payment of tax and submission of tax returns, create personalized tax portal where taxpayers can access their tax profile, beef up the IT departments to own and lead in the development of IT infrastructure and applications for revenue administration. Mr. Chairman, we also need to tackle base erosion and profit shifting. Base erosion and profit shifting is not only prevalent in the extractive industries, but in other sectors as well. To solve this, we need to address the skills gap, especially in auditing and investigations. Finally, we need to build adequate tax policy making capacity within our governments in the following areas: tax policy design, micro simulation and tax incident analysis, and tax gap analysis. African countries are embarking on a challenging new world together. One that requires dramatic improvements in our tax revenue mobilization strategies so that we can aggressively pursue poverty reduction and economic development. There is no denying the fact that our future as a continent depends on the quantum of taxes we are able to raise domestically. No nation has ever developed depending principally on the benevolence of other people. Aid must be a dispensable supplement to our domestic efforts. This one we should come for. Thank you. The ideal tax system in these countries should enable government to raise essential revenue without excessive government borrowing, and should do so without discouraging economic activity and without deviating too much from time-tested norms in taxation. Even though tax payment has never been a pleasant experience for anybody living in the developed world, it is also the fact that taxation is a price we pay to live in civilized and peaceful societies. We should clap for this one as well. And I'll say that again, even though tax payment has never been a pleasant experience for anybody, even in the developed world, it is also the fact that taxation is the price we pay to live in civilized and peaceful societies. According to according to the World Economic and Financial Service, IMF, sub-Saharan African countries could mobilize, on the average, up to 5% of GDP in additional tax revenue in the next few years. While this sounds good, experience suggests that the conditions for success require attention to many factors related to policy design, institutional development. In conclusion, I have no doubt that with the quality and management of the professionals gathered here, we will have some homegrown innovations that will have a positive impact on this vision. I wish us all fruitful deliberations. I thank you very much for your attention.